first trip in June, and we were rounding a bunch of kids up to go play at the park. And, you know, we kind of all split up and went house to house, you know, driving the truck around, blaring music, and really tried to get all these kids in one location. And, you know, it was our first night there, and we, you know, we probably had, you know, a couple dozen kids. And so I'm playing basketball with a lot of them and running around and playing tag. And I look over, and there's this kid in a wheelchair that's playing frisbee with my grandma. And I go over to him. Actually, his sister takes me over to him, and I'm sitting there talking to her. And he just takes a water bottle and just dumps it all over me. And I look at him like, who are you? And I kind of just like shrugged it off. He was talking, you know, a bunch of kids were around us. And they did it again. And so I'm like, that's it. And I take the water bottle from him, and I just dump an entire water bottle on top of his head. And his sister, who's right next to me, this is my brother Lakin.
With his maternal grandmother in Eagle Butte. Lakin was in the back seat of that car, and apparently there was a drunk driver. He was a non-Indian. They called him into the non-Indian police. How it is on our reservations, you have to call the non-Indian police. And so they notified them, and the Indian police couldn't do anything about it and stop him because he was a white guy. So he was racing down Main Street 50 miles an hour on 212, and they were stopped at the light, and he rear-ended them. And there used to be a gas station across the street, and he pushed them into the pumps. And they didn't know Lakin was in the back there when the ambulances came and everything like that. The left side of the car behind the driver's seat has the most damage, and that's where Lakin was, is in that side of it, and he was behind there. They airlifted him to Sioux Falls. This is in November 17th, I think it was, and he stayed there till May. Spine is not broken, but it's like bent like that. They said he might not be able to talk. They said he might not be able to feed himself. We were so scared, and he's really smart. He's a straight A student.
I was just sitting there, just looking at the house outside, and I was just, you know, in awe of it. All kind of hit me like, this kid needs freedom. This kid needs to be able to get outside on his own and not be so cramped up in that house. And I, you know, it was just like, we can build a ramp for him.
A lot of prayer and God's support and help, and we made it work, and it was incredible being able to do that for him, for God.
And seeing him with a smile on his face going down the ramp for the first time was made everything worth it, all the backaches, everything. all the little suffering that we had to go through, the sacrifice for him in that moment just made everything worth it.
What you guys have done has really given him a freedom that he didn't have before, you know. He'd have to say, Grandma, I want to go outside. So we'd take him outside and then have to go check on him because sometimes it's too hot or if it's cold, or if he's too cold. Now he could just come in and he's not going to be wondering if somebody's going to come look and see if he needs to come in. So it's going to really be a good thing that he'll just be able to do it on his own, you know.
I could get out of the house.
And what makes it easier now to get out of the house?
The ramp.
Ooh, you like the ramp?
Yeah.
You guys worked on that shower and fixed it for him. It's a big deal. He can now wheel his way in there and wheel into the shower and take a shower. That is such a good thing. Like I said, we're blessed. We can get up and go and jump in a shower, take a bath, whatever. Go on about our business, but for him, it's a big issue. And now, he can do it himself. He can actually go in there because I told him, get undressed. You're going to go take a shower. He got undressed, got ready, transferred over, took him in there, showered up. That was so cool. It really feels good to be able to do that in his own home. It's really good. I don't have to call up his dad and say, so when he takes Lakin to give him a bath, we don't have to set times. Well, I'm going to be working today, or I got this to do, so maybe later on, you know, now we can decide he needs a shower and he can take a shower.
What else do you like that we helped you with?
My shower and my grandma's house.
And you guys, you call yourselves world changers.
Yes.
I think you guys did an awesome job. You really changed his world.
Bottom line is we might have changed Lakin's life just a little bit. And whether it was just being his friend, whether it was just building him a ramp, whether it was allowing him to shower in his own house, you know, we impacted him a little bit. But the greatest impact of all comes from what he did for us and our students and just the way he changed our hearts and the way he changed the way we think of things, the way we act, the way we live our own lives. And that's the greatest impact of all is just his light and his ability to change the lives of so many without really trying.
I think Lakin has changed how I can love other people and just love them for who they are and love like never ending. And just like since we gave our all to him and he just loved us right back. It just shows us how much like we really need to love, and it shows me how much I can love others and put that out there.
No!
No! Not a dirty surface.
Oh! The champion!
When I got to go to therapy with Lakin was definitely an eye-opener. And to see him actually do it and stand up and get out of that wheelchair is something that I will also never forget about him. I mean, there's just no words that can describe that moment. I felt like he is limitless to everything that he puts his mind to. He made me laugh and made me forget about a bunch of things that I was stressed out about over the week, and just kind of like time froze when I was with him.
To have the perspective on life that he did, it just taught me that no matter what comes in my life, I should be able to handle it with a positive outlook and an ability to take it for what it is and
and to love myself and everyone through the process.
This kid is so happy, and we make him happy, but like a lot of us struggle to find our own happiness when it's kind of right in front of us. And I think Lakin helped me realize just that like I have all this stuff going on, but you know, you're here in this moment right now with me and you, and to kind of just find the happiness within that, within the small things.